Mitch, what have you seen just from having Byron in the building so far, with his staff, with how he's interacted with the players? I know a lot of this will come to bear during training camp, but what kind of an impact do you think that can make with the reason that you decided to hire him?
Byron's been great. You know, he's in every day with his staff. They meet in the morning. They're on the court. There's only so much we can do in terms of the rules, you know, so he can't, you know, be out there with his staff, you know, putting players through drills and coaching, so to speak. But we're allowed to sit back and watch guys scrimmage. Very, very pleased. You know, I think the one thing he's going to do is really hold players accountable. And, you know, much has been made of his, you know, desire to improve the team defensively. I think he'll do that as well. But he hasn't coached a lot of these guys, and a lot of them are going to have to, you know, understand how Byron's going to coach, and he's going to have to understand, you know, what they can bring to the table, and that happens in training camp.
How often are you guys communicating?
Byron and I? Mm-hmm. Every day. You know, in order to get to the court, he has to walk past my office. So, you know, sometimes they walk past quickly, and sometimes, but either way, I see them. And he'll hear me yell out Byron. So we communicate every day.
Mitch, what are you expecting from your two rookies? I know Byron's going to have to stay on the minutes and everything, but can they make a substantial impact this season?
Remains to be seen. Julius is still 19 years old. Now, you wouldn't know that by looking at him, because he's really, you know, a well-developed, big, strong, athletic kid. And, you know, you would think that at 19 years old, you know, that would be down the road. But he's still 19 years old. And Jordan came out as an underclassman as well. So, personally, you know, when you look at, you know, who's going to affect the team during the season, over the years, I've never looked at a rookie and said, hey, this guy is going to bring us to the top. You know, it doesn't do any good to have high expectations, you know, of a player like that. I'm hopeful that during the course of the season and training camp, they'll both continue to improve, stay healthy, work hard. And it may be where it's three steps forward, two steps back, two steps forward, you know, one step back. I don't expect, you know, him to hit the ground or either rookie to hit the ground running and put together 82 great games. That doesn't happen with a veteran, and it's been very rare, unless the team was really, really bad, that you see that happen with a rookie.
I think it was Nick Young in an interview with you, Mike, who was saying that the difference with this year and last year, he said that this year, players are coming in, there's a completely different vibe than last year. Are you noticing that too? And if so, what is that?
Who said that?
Nick Young.
It's hard for me to say, to be honest with you. The preseason, I mean, there's a newness to it, you know, clearly. I mean, Kobe's ready to go. Last year he wasn't, and we didn't know when he'd get back. So we are entering the season, you know, with our roster basically intact. And the team that we're expecting to field on opening day, you know, hopefully we'll play on opening day. So that leads to a good feeling all around. I will say the players that we've had in here, you know, whether they're trying to prove something or some of them that know there's a roster spot available, they've been working very hard. Of course, I mentioned earlier, it's great to see Steve Nash in here in the morning playing full court and then coming back at night. So those are all positive things that maybe leads to a better feeling. But training camp will let us know where we stand.
What does what you've seen so far from Kobe mean to you? Does it change anything in your mind as you compared to months ago? What does it mean for you?
Well, it's comforting to know that he will be here for two more years, and you know he's healthy. And with him on the court, we're always going to have a chance to win games. And if we're lucky enough to have acquired a player during the off season that plays better than expected, or if we can get somebody during the season, and that's not to say that we will, then you can have a really, really good team. So he gives you a chance no matter the circumstances, to be really good.